Good morning, Kumanda. I am going to teach today's class the basics of optical communication. The first term, the keyword is Snell's law, refractive index, meridional light rays, and I will end with block diagram. So I am going to start my lecture with the basic concepts of optical communication, which starts with the Snell's law, and I will go to the refractive index, next meridional light rays, and I am going to be end today with the block diagram of optical communication. Now we will start with the Snell's law. So before going to the Snell's law, let me convert the technical knowledge into the domestical way, which will elaborate and which gives you the very very basic knowledge of the optical communication system. First, let me take a torch light. So when I am going to make use of the torch light, when we are going to be projecting on your wall, automatically what will happen? Some light ray is going to be reflected back. So it is going to be incidence and it is going to be reflected back. So that is the main concept what we are going to be making use in case of the optical communication. Now let me come to the technical terms. So here I am going to make use the reference as this one. So the light ray is going to be projected and it is going to be incident at this particular location. Okay, let me consider it is going to be the wall. So when the light ray is going to be incident with certain angle, let me take this theta 1 as the incident angle. So the light ray is penetrates through this wall or it will pass like this, because here I am going to be making use two hetero medium. One is N1 and another one is going to be representing with N2. N1 means it is nothing but refractive index. The second term what I am going to use. So the definition of refractive index is velocity of light in A divided by velocity of light in the medium. The definition of refractive index is, it is the ratio of velocity of light in A divided by the velocity of light in the medium. So here I am going to be making use two different refractive media which has the refractive index of N1 as well as N2. So here the condition I am going to be applying, N1 is greater than N2. So automatically what will happen, when the light ray is going to be incident, when it is going to be passing through the another medium which has the refractive index of N2, which condition is going to force to, that is N1 is greater than N2. So automatically the light ray is going to, means the angle of refraction is going to be high. So theta 1, here it will become theta 2. So according to the definition of the Snell's law, or according to the Snell's law, here N1, that is refractive index N1, sin theta 1 is equal to N2 sin theta 2. So sin theta 1 divided by sin theta 2 is equal to N2 minus N1. So the Snell's law says that the angle of reflection as well as refraction is going to be deals with the refractive indices N2 and N1. So directly we can tell this is the relationship as per the Snell's law. Now here in next case what I am going to make use is the same concept. Here I am going to be making use, when I am going here, if I will increase this angle of incidence, automatically what will happen, the refracted light ray will come and meet to this particular reference point what I have been considered over here. So here I am going to be increasing, okay, this is my the gentlemen, now I am going to be increasing the angle of incidence. So automatically this is the first case, whereas coming to the second case, the angle of refraction is going to be taking place. Once again, if I am going to be increasing the angle of incidence, so at certain angle, the light ray is passing through the interface of M1 and M2. Means when we are going to be increasing the angle of incidence, at certain angle, the light ray passes through the interface of N1 and N2. So here, let me consider at certain angle, it will pass through this one. So it is going to be theta 2. Now, let me apply the Snell's law. So according to Snell's law, it is nothing but S1 sin theta 1 is equal to S2 sin theta 2. Coming to the second step, S1 sin theta 1 divided by sin theta 2 is equal to N2 divided by N1. So now here sin theta 1 is going to be as usual sin theta 1. Whereas coming to sin theta, means theta 2 is going to be exactly normal to the reference point what I am going to be considering. So here it is going to be, we can say exactly 90 degrees. So your theta 2 is nothing but 90 degrees. So if I am going to be subjecting the same one, N2 divided by N1 is equal to sin theta 1 divided by sin theta 2. This theta 2 is nothing but 90 degrees. So directly I can tell sin theta 1. Since sin 90 degrees is equal to 1. So in this case, in second case, directly we can tell that N2 divided by N1 is equal to sin theta 1. But here it is going to be, the condition is theta 2 is going to be 90 degrees. So when it is going to be 90 degrees, the light ray, that is the refracted light ray, is passing through the interface of N1 and N2. That condition or that angle we used to call it as critical angle. So critical angle is the angle where the incident light ray is passing through the interface of both N1 as well as N2. So the one more key term here we have come across to is critical angle. So now we have completed this nice law. Next we have moved to the critical angle. Now I am going to be considering the third case. Here I can say. So in case of third case, the same, it is going to be subjected. I am going to mention the same value. When I am going to be increasing the angle of incidence at critical angle, the light ray is passing through the interface of N1 as well as N2. Let me consider, if when I am going to be increasing this angle of incidence, automatically what will happen? The light ray is come to the original medium. When I am going to be keeps on increasing the angle of incidence, okay, the light ray is passing through the original medium. So here it is going to be theta 1, here it is going to be theta 2. So now if we are going to apply the Snell's law, N1 sin theta 1 is equal to N2 sin theta 2. So here sin theta 1 divided by sin theta 2 is equal to N2 divided by N1. Here we are going to be making the same one. So here we can conclude that when the angle of incidence is going to be greater than the critical angle, the light rays are going to be reflected back into the original medium. So it is going to be, we have started with the Snell's law, we have entered with the critical angle. If we are going to be increasing the critical angle, the light rays are going to be reflected back into the original medium. So that angle where the light rays are going to be reflected back into the original medium, we can call such angle as the acceptance angle. So refractive index, next we have added the critical angle, now we are in the acceptance angle. So acceptance angle is the angle where going to be? The light ray is going to be reflected back. Okay. And it is passing through the cable. So the total internal reflection is going to be taking place. So the other keyword here we have is total internal reflection. So critical angle, next acceptance angle, the light rays are which are under the acceptance angle, we can call this, it will go for the total internal reflection. So the light rays which are under the total internal reflection are going to be taking the throughout the system, the communication is going to be taking place and it is going to be received by the receiver section. Okay. Now we will move the block diagram. Next I will come back to this meridional light ray. Because based upon this total internal reflection, which is that is going to be under the acceptance angle, we can divide the light rays into two types. One is meridional one, the other one is going to be spurious. Okay, so we will come back this meridional rays as well as spurious later. Now we will move to the block diagram. So here, now let me start the block diagram with the basics of the communication system. So the basic block diagram of the communication system is nothing but very first block is transmitter section and this is the medium or the channel we are going to be making and it is going to be received by the receiver. So we can broadly divide into three types. The three blocks are transmitter section, channel or medium and the receiver section. The optical communication we are going to be making use, okay, the source as the only light ray. So now in the transmitter section we should have the source as the light ray. So for that say the information source we are going to be the first block. From that information source, it is going to be subjected with the light source. Means the information is going to be converted as the light and it is going to be passing through the channel. Okay. So here the channel, of course, it is going to be the wide medium. So I am going to be representing here it is going to be detected. Of course, here we will have the destination part. So now let me here the transmitter section I have divided into the first block is going to the information and it is going to be transmitted to the source. Okay. So here that light rays means the information one, it is going to be converted, means here it is going to be converted as a light source. Means here it is acting as a transducer. Means it is going to be converting one form of energy into another form of energy. So in general we can call it as this whole block is going to be just like the transducer. Okay. So here if we are means the source is going to be converted as a voltage and that particular voltage is going to be subjected to the light source. Okay. Based upon that the parameters like frequency or the wavelength, all the parameters are going to be varies according to this light radiance or the brightness of the light. Okay, so here the information source is going to be converted in the form of the light. So here